All right, here we are back at it, leg two, starting here in Barcelona, Spain. Barcelona, España. This is cool. I like Barcelona. It's a pretty modern, clean, nice city as far as the aspects of it that I'm seeing or where we're staying right now. I'm sure there's equal and opposite aspects as well to be found within the city limits here. Anyway, Barcelona, home of, among many other things, cheese plates. You know, you know. Yeah. How you doing, man? Guess what? I'm a tourist. Speaking English into my iPhone as I'm walking down the street. I'm fucking gonna be 46 this year, man. I don't give a shit about being cool anymore. Morning, Barcelona. What's happening? Got myself a double espresso here. Ready to go, baby. So we got our first show, leg two, here today in Rockfest in Barcelona. And I'm thinking about and the idea that the way that we see things out here, the way I see things, and I mean, anyone else who tours, is through the lens of a traveling musician, man. Through the lens of the transient world of rock and roll, you know, it's not real, not actually the way things are. That's okay. I mean, no tourist is ever really gonna see or understand a place that they visit for what it actually is, unless you decide to up and move there, which I'm not gonna say is impossible, but from where I'm standing right now, it's pretty unlikely that I'm gonna ever live in Barcelona. And that's all right. But just know that when I make these videos and I show these things to you, that I know that everything is heavily biased through the lens of my own eye, essentially, you know. And that's that. So now I'm gonna get on with it. And it's never too early for ice cream. Festival France, Marmande, France, and I'm on a mission to go find a thing that they call the vinyl factory, where I'm gonna determine whether they're gonna lend me some sunglasses or give me some sunglasses. As you can see, I'm wearing sunglasses, so I don't need a pair, but Sunglasses and me have a very limited lifespan together. Paid about $5 for these, and they probably are gonna live for about another week. So, let's see what we got going on here. There's the main stage where we're gonna play later. You can see behind it in the distance, there's another stage there. It's not open to the public yet, but this will be filled with people, hopefully. A little bit later on today. Yeah, all right. Golf carts abound at these festivals. That's how you get around, man. I don't ride on golf carts because A, I'm not fancy enough, and B, I like to get my steps in. But there's lots of golf carts at a festival. I don't know about golf clubs, but carts, yes. Le pipe, oui. Yeah, man. So this is not where I'm gonna find sunglasses. Let's see what else they got going on. Probably in the artist zone I just came from. Yeah. That's another mode of transportation you're gonna see a lot of at a festival. Fucking four-wheelers and bikes. Bonjour. All right, I haven't found the sunglass place yet, but look at this like little like wannabe beach cabana that they set up here. These little swimming pools. Are you kidding me, dude? Got a wicked hammock going over there. Let's see, test out. Oh, that water is, that's cool and refreshing, man. Look at this. They got the little changing huts here. Showers afterwards. They put a bunch of sand on the ground. Got some floaty toys there to play with. Wow. I must say, in the 15, 16 years or so of traveling over here to Europe to festivals, I have never seen a rig like this before. Who's this? There's the classic move right there. Vodka in the water bottles, baby. Festival life.
There's a ton of different festivals.
Yeah, this is just the season, baby.
Give it down.
Is that the way you talk in the shower at home? Eric Pinkos.
Hi, Kevin.
At Garro Rock Festival in France.
What festival? What's this called?
Garro Rock?
Oh, yeah, Garro Rock.
Yeah.
It's nice.
It's nice, right?
Are we gonna go swimming later?
I was going to say, are you going to get... If you and Johnny are the top candidates to get in that pool, man.
If I don't get in that pool after the set... Just send me home.
All right. I'm not even going to start to make arrangements because I know you're going in there.
Yeah.
All right, at long last, I found where they're giving out the sunglasses, and I got myself a pair, and I'm wearing them right now. They're doing a pretty good job, except the sun is directly in my face. Yeah. They're called, what's the name of the place? Vinyl Factory sunglasses. Don't want to be an American idiot. Don't want a nation under the new media. But can you hear the sound of the stereo? Subliminal mind, fuck America. Went to a new kind of junction. And they cross the area mission. All right, here I am walking over to the Paris La Défense Arena to go see Green Day again. But really, I'm going to see Amel and Sniffers. I haven't seen them yet. I've been hearing a lot about them. And my buddy last night said, you got to check them out if you got a chance. So here we are in Paris, the day off. Got an opportunity to go check them out. So how can I say no? I took the subway here, man. It was crazy. Dudes are chucking like full cans of beer off a ledge of people and shit. Shit is wild. All right, I got my ticket and I'm out here waiting to get in. But scanners are busted. Yeah, man, I was supposed to go. It said 32, but my ticket says 34 on it. And I'm in this wicked long line now. There's no way I'm going to catch that first stamp. It's the only reason I came. All right, I'm leaving. I didn't get to see anything. I'm going to call that an epic fail, man. I should have come earlier and got my ticket and made sure that I got inside to see the opening band, which is the reason I wanted to come. No offense to Green Day or Weezer, they're both great bands, but I saw Green Day last night. Base of the Eiffel Tower. This is absolute madness.
Should you pay? Let this be a lesson. Like a fool or wrong, don't go messing with another man's wife. At least take a look, see if she's wearing red. She has been a run for your life. She broke my heart, then he broke my jaw. She broke my heart, then he broke my jaw.
Rear Pod Rodeo. Good morning, Wurzburg. Check this out. We are our upstairs, our upper bus window here on the bus we ride on is damaged, smashed. At first it started with a little crack, Barcelona, and now it's really bad. So we're having it replaced here. You can see from the inside here a little bit better how badly it's cracked and fucked up. Mid-process.
Here I am in Wurzburg, Germany. Wurzburg, Deutschland. We got a show here today in a place called Post Hall.
And I'm walking through town to go to check out some interesting local sites.
It's a nice little town here.
Wurzburg, Deutschland. I believe we're in Bavaria, which is pretty sweet. It's like the heart of Germany, if you will. Or back in the old days, it was like its own separate zone. Bavaria. So now I'm at this place where I was directed to check out called Residence Plots. I'm sure I'm saying it like a real fucking cowboy. Residence Plots. The gist is in this town, the Allies, or the British, bombed the hell out of the place during the Second World War. And the people here had to rebuild it, like in many places in Europe. Go inside the grounds of this place and see what it's all about. Residence plots. All right, so this is like a little area where people sit down and eat and stuff. And there's all these over here to my right. There's like a corridor of vendors, it looks like. Only a couple of them are open. They're selling like pretzels and cheese things. But there's like a wine bar here behind me. You can see it's not open yet. There's a few other places that aren't open. Looks like they got some glasses set up here for a fancy thing that's gonna happen. It's a very like, I just walked right in. It's open to the public. It's a very beautiful place here. Nice grounds and everything. It's pretty cool. Well, I'm chilling with my homie here, this guy. It's like there's a different one of these little kind of people underneath every one of these little gumdrop shrubs. See those like Candyland looking bushes there? There's a different one under each shrub. That's a gratifying detail, you know? The devil is in the details, man, but look, this guy is dope too. He's like playing on a wicked flute. Check him out there. That's my guy. Musician, shrub man. That's my guy.
Some people like the world.
Here's the read I get on Avignon, France. It's historical.
And even the girl was like, I don't know why you got these.
Very touristy. Fellow Americans, you can hear them speaking English right there. It's impossibly quaint. I mean, the streets that I'm walking down are just ridiculous, man. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. Very, very cool place. Very cool place. Avignon, France. Wow. All right, here's another thing about Avignon, France that I just want to note. They got the ice cream game on lockdown. The gelato game is strong. It's all over the place. You can't walk like 5 feet without seeing somebody selling gelato. So that's a win.
All right, everyone, thanks for hanging out with me. That's gonna be a wrap for part two, and stay tuned for more Fun of the Sun coming up in part three. Till then, take care.